Hello students, today we are going to learn Two My of the Elephants, written by Rudyard Kipling, grade 6, chapter 3, subject English. Before we continue, let us know something about Rudyard Kipling. Rudyard Kipling was born on 30th December 1865 and he died on 18th January 1936. He was born in Bombay in India. And he pursued his studies in England. He also worked as a journalist. In 1894, he published his book, The Jungle Book, which everyone knows about, I'm sure. His book has been translated into many languages, as well as it has been made into many movies and animated series. The antagonist or the villain in the story is the tiger Sher Khan. In 1907, he was given the Nobel Prize in Literature, and this was given in consideration of the power of observation, originality of imagination, virility of idea, and remarkable talent for narration, which characterizes the creation of the world famous author. His other works which are famous are Just So Stories, Kim, and the poem If. Now, Two My of the Elephants. Two My of the Elephants is originally based on the story The Jungle Book. It's a part of the book Jungle Book. And here's the poem. I will remember what I was. I am sick of rope and chain. I will remember my old strength and all my forest affairs. So out here the elephant is most probably in chain and under pressure from the humans to do his bidding, to do the human's bidding. So he, the elephant, is remembering his old days. He was sick of ropes and chains, the ropes and chains that were bound to him, that was tied to him. He says, the elephant thinks and says, he will remember his old strength and all his forest affairs. I will not sell my back to man for a bundle of sugarcane. I will go out to my own kind and the wood folk in their lairs. So the elephant out here is saying, I will not do any kind of slavery for a few bundles of sugarcane. Now everyone knows that elephants love to eat sugarcane. So the humans think they can easily bribe the elephants by a few sugarcanes and allow them to do their hard work. Okay, so the elephant has made a promise to himself that he will not allow man to use him or make him work for him just for a few bundles of sugarcane. He says that he will go to his own kind. His own kind means the people, the animals of the jungle or another group of elephants. I will go out until the day, until the morning break, out to the winds, untainted kiss, the water clean caress. I will forget my ankle ring and snap my picket stick. I will visit my love lost and playmates masterless. So out here the elephants are saying, I will go out until that day. He will go out, means escape. Okay, until the morning breaks, until there's a new day where all the elephants are free, where they are not in chains anymore. Out to the wind, untainted kiss. Untainted kiss out here, it means where there is no person to harm the elephants. The waters clean caress, where the waters are clean. You know, in the city, the waters are polluted. There's a lot of germs and other kind of impurities. But in the forest, where it is untouched by human hands, the water is clean. So out here, the elephant is trying to talk about the clean water in the jungle. I will forget my ankle ring and snap my picket stick. Out here, the elephant is saying, I will forget my ankle ring. Ankle ring means those heavy round chains which are tied to the ankles of the elephant. And I will snap my picket stick. And he will break open the picket stick. Okay. I will revisit my lost loves. So the elephant is saying he will go and visit all his loved and dear ones who are still in the jungle, and playmates masterless. Playmates means his childhood friends, most probably and he will visit them freely without any master to guide him. You must have seen people taking elephants with them. So that is with master. So out here the elephant is trying to say, I will go and meet my lost loves and playmates without any master, masterless. So students, can you see the pictures given? How brutally the elephants are being tortured. They are tied in chain, they are put in big pits. They are made to do the work that human beings give them. They are killed and used for humans' entertainment. Now, what do we learn from the poem, or what is the moral of the poem? We learn that we should never be cruel towards animals. Animals are born free like us and should never be made to do hard work for us. Chaining up animals and forcing them to be our slaves is a very cruel thing to do. Now the rhyming scheme of the poem. Dear students, can you see the lines? And at the end of the line there is A, B, A, B written. That A, B, A, B is the rhyming scheme. So how do we understand what is rhyming scheme? Let's read the first line of the poem. I will remember what I was. I am sick of ropes and chains. Now let's go to the third line. I will not sell my back to man for a bundle of sugarcane. Can you see the first line, the last word, and the third line, the last word? Chain, sugarcane. It's rhyming, isn't it? So when we find out the rhyming scheme of a poem, we take the last word of the first line and the last word of the second line or the third line. So in this case, it is coming as A, B, A, B. So the rhyming scheme of the poem is A, B, A, B. So dear students, I hope you have understood this poem and enjoyed this video. Till then, take care. Goodbye.